On my flight into Zurich, I flew on Swiss Air. And once again, I was in an aircraft that had a flag painted on its tail. And what an anachronism that is. Of course, Swiss Air is now owned by Lufthansa and is no longer a national carrier, but I remember a time when every airline had a flag on its tail, when every airline was a national airline and had exclusive and monopoly access to the skies and the airports of a country. I remember a time when phone companies had flags and belonged exclusively to countries. Those anachronisms are gone. And the idea in the near future, in a few decades, of money that has a flag or a queen on it that belongs exclusively to a single nation will seem like a silly anachronism. It won't go away, of course. There will still be national money, but there will also be many, hundreds, possibly thousands, of international monies, monies that have no flag, monies that have no allegiance to any country, and more importantly, monies that are neutral to geopolitics. There is enormous power to a system of money that is neutral to geopolitics, a system of money that depends on mathematical functions, that can be inspected by everyone, that doesn't change its nature according to the latest alliances and hostilities between nations, that remains a stable and neutral backdrop to all trade globally, a money of the internet, for the internet, and by the internet. And that kind of thing can sound quite terrifying, honestly. And if you're terrified by that, you're probably also a bit worried about how the internet allowed free expression for everyone. But I can tell you, there's a generation of people who are growing up right now who, when they hear the idea of money of the internet, by the internet, and for the internet, think that this is the most natural thing, that this is how it should be.